It's safe to say that last night was a bit of a pleasant surprise with the Aniplex Festa of 2022. With, of course, we having the Bleach event going on, which only lasted for about 10 minutes, which generally surprised me. But I didn't really go into this expecting much more than maybe a voice actor interview and maybe some information about the four cores. Two of them, which were actually correct. But what I didn't actually expect was a new PV, let alone free. So if you wasn't there for that live stream, of course I did have a live reaction to that PV, which I will be showing here, but of course the stream got copyrighted, so it's gonna have to be edited, but it is on YouTube if you want to go see it. But here you go. VTR, oh, brand new PV. Chad? Oh shit. Hey yo. Okay, Sakuga, there you go. Orihime! Hey, let's go! Let's sell this quickly, nice. Oh, yeah! Oh, come on! Hey! 15 second TV spot, as I said, let's go! That's great! That was the first episode. They showed the first episode. That was really cool. I like that. Now, of course, I was very stunned. I didn't expect anything, and I didn't really, you know what to say going into this, as the chat was going crazy and everything was so fast-paced. A lot of cuts within this episode. So I'm going to be watching this again now that I've slept after staying up all night for this stream, and kind of just re-giving my thoughts about what I, you know, generally think after some time of watching it. I haven't really watched it since. So let's go. Talk about Ungrateful. So right off the bat, we get our people being Uryu, Ichigo, and Orihime and Chad, which is great. I think there's a new Chad clip in there somewhere. Actually, you know, as we know, there's going to be more clips as we go along, just to pad out the episode, which is good. And I like that little Chad shot right there. There's a new OST. And again, I saw people on Twitter talk about they didn't really like this. But again, it's really just been thrown in there. So again, with context, I might feel different about it. But so far, I'm kind of neutral on it. We're here. Whoa, that was a close call. Your arrows were really more dangerous. That was a good shot, actually. I want to just re-look at that. And Ichigo seems to be standing there. Oh, and you get a nice little dodge there, actually. That's cute. Like, Ichigo's just watching from afar as Uryu's just, like, demolishing all these hollows. From the top, it seems like he's shooting down from the sky. And Ichigo, like, he can see where they're going to be, which is good because it kind of shows Ichigo's his reaction speed in that sense. I'm not going to try and get power scaly. But it's almost comedic in this sense, and I like this a lot, actually. This is quite funny. Just goes to show the severity or the seriousness that these guys are taking these hollows in comparison to when we saw, you know, and again, I don't really want to go into a breakdown, so to say, but at the very start of the war where you see, like, Ichigo and the gang show up and it was kind of, like, done and dusted with one kind of get-to-get Tensho. It seems that they are kind of having a laugh with this, or, you know, I assume a bit of a joke, which is good. I think it's cool because, again, these are our four main casts are overpowered, so these hollows shouldn't be that much of an issue. And it just, again, goes to show what a Soul Reaper coming into new duties, doing, like, you know, duty and surveillance in, you know, the world of the living in comparison to where our heroes are now. So, again, I'm just jabbering on, so let's get to it. We have Nell. This is after she's fell from the sky in the previous PV that you saw, and they land onto the ground. There's a big crater, and they are in a park. Now, I believe this background wasn't shown because in the manga panel, I believe it was just kind of like whited out. So, and I'll show you that reference in a bit, but yeah, that's cool. I was thinking about how you and Kurosaki become such good friends. Orihime, bread girl. You know, I don't know why that kicked off, but it did. Chad, there's no need to ask. We're going to help them, right? Of course, this is the Donda Chaka thing, maybe. Let's settle this quickly. This is what I'm really impressed of before I carry on, and you're going to see it, is Orihime absolutely doing bits. Like, you'll see here, she just pushes this hollow away, and that's a new attack. Like, that seems like a new attack, like a force field, kind of like just telekinetic attack like that just pushes. Again, I don't know the context, I haven't seen the episode, but I think it's really cool because, again, look at the effects, and I think the effects are really going to play a part in really creating a lot of impact. So, reject, and she looks great. La Muerte, and Uryu. Yeah, just wow. Again, so I've seen a few things on Twitter, which is, again, it's Twitter. But hey, look, it's an opinion nonetheless, and we should address it, is that many people are fearing that, you know, this PV isn't really showing enough animation. And, you know, it looks mediocre. I completely disagree. And, of course, always a Bleach fan. No, I generally do. There is not one frame in this. Well, a frame is a still frame. But, you know, there's not a sequence or cut within this trailer that has still movements. Like, everyone's moving to some degree. So there is fluidity in animation. I feel like people compare it to Chainsaw Man too much because of, like, they go over the top. But you've got to understand from a perspective, and I might do a video about this scenes as we are coming closer to that October airtime with Chainsaw Man and Bleach, is that I fear that people don't understand there's a difference between animating one character and showing their expressions in comparison to animating five characters within a shot. And I think people really misunderestimate Bleach's value with that, is that you have 80 characters in an episode. You know, you have at least five characters or at least two characters on screen at the same time, and you've got to animate all of those facial expressions, all of those movements. While with Chainsaw Man, from what we've seen, is that they are really focusing, from the PVs that we've seen, it's like one character shots and really exaggerating their expressions. And I don't think they're comparable, because it's a bit unfair, because you're asking for extra work on Pierrot's part, which again, they've done astounding work so far from what I've seen. So that's kind of my thoughts on the PV. Very cool. I enjoyed the hell out of it. Again, that OST, want to hear what context it's going to be used, but I can see that in a really high battle fight, maybe against Ibern. Very excited for that. And again, just a gorgeous looking PV. And I mentioned earlier that we're going to be getting three PVs. This was the first PV of the ones to come. The next one is going to be on the 1st of October, and then the third one is going to be on the 8th of October, just in time for the Viz event at New York Comic Con. So we're going to be getting the Star Knights, or the Storm Reapers, whatever you want to call them, on the 1st, and then we're going to get the Soul Reapers on the 8th, I believe. It doesn't really matter. It's either one or the other. So, and again, this was mainly, all of it, 100% was episode one, which we already know is done. We know episode one and two is done. So they're probably going to flaunt a lot of that, especially with the Storm Reapers and the Soul Reapers as well. So I'm really excited to see those as well. But it's really cool to see different dynamic lighting ranges with Karakura Town and Ichigo's room and just the world of the living in general. So in regards to the cause, we did get some information on the cause. Granted, it was information that we already knew. Morita, the voice actor of Ichigo, just basically said that it is going to be four cores, and there wasn't really any defining definition on what those cores would be. So as far as we know, or as far as I'm confident to say, is that it is going to be singular cores based off like the episode counts that I know that exists so far. So again, singular cores, good sign. I like that. I've explained on stream why I like that. If you guys want me to go deeper into why I like the single core program more, tell me in the comment section down below. I can do a video on that explaining why this is beneficial for many different reasons other than giving the staff more time. And then of course we also have the streaming dilemma, which I'll briefly touch upon. I think, you know, and as I said on stream, it is extremely sad that, you know, we're potentially a very high chance going to be waiting at least 2 days before broadcast to find out where this is going to be streamed or where the platform is going to be. And I say that because obviously that's poor marketing. Every anime series for fall is getting promoted in the West except for Bleach. And I mean, look, Viz can put trailers up the ass, bro, but you know, it's not really exclusive to us, is it? It's not really, it's an obligatory thing, not really marketing that they're doing off their own bat, which is unfortunate. Now, there was streaming talk within this live stream. However, I want to parenthesis something, and you can go back, the Aniplex stream is there for you all to go watch. The host, the female host that was talking about American streaming services, is that the context to that discussion was in relation to talking about Bleach in the past. The Japanese audience wanted to know how she watched Bleach in the past, and she talks about in America specifically, because she lived in LA, talked about how Bleach was on many different streaming platforms, as we know, such as Netflix, Hulu, Crunchyroll, etc., etc. This wasn't anything new. If anything, there was no streaming talk in regards to the new Thousand Year Blood War arc whatsoever. So I do want to put that to bed, that that was the context behind that, which is unfortunate. It's true, but it's unfortunate. So every other series at Aniplex got their announcements of where they would be streamed and what dates they would be streaming at and what platforms. All series but Bleach. And maybe it will make sense when it gets announced, but at the moment it is looking pretty bad on Viz's part. Pretty bad. Yeah, that's kind of my thoughts on the whole thing. Tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below of what you liked and disliked about this trailer. What did you think of the music? And what do you think about the whole streaming dilemma? Other than that, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hansen, as always, people. Peace out!